Hello and welcome to Korea Overlander. My name is Ben and welcome back to the channel, everyone. I hope you are all doing very, very well. Today we are going to talk about foot care when we go hiking and anytime we are outdoors. So stay tuned and don't touch that dial. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And stay tuned because there is a special video coming up this Saturday. I'm going to be heading up, actually, which is tomorrow. I'm going to be heading up to Suwon Convention Center for a camping fair that they have up there. So stay tuned for that video. Don't forget to hit the notification button so when it does pop into your feed, you will see that it is ready to go. But today, let me get right into the topic. We're talking about foot care. I'm going to leave all the links that I've looked at down below in the description below. Feel free, of course, to go check those out. So, five things that you need to consider. Number one, so I'm going to call this footwear because it does depend on what hike you're doing. If you're going on a day hike, maybe a hiking shoe is okay. If you're doing something multi-day, maybe a boot would be more appropriate. You could go barefoot hiking. There's all sorts of alternatives that you can use for hiking. But let me talk about footwear and a couple things in there. First of all, how do you fit a boot? A couple things that I would suggest not doing. Don't go to a big box store to find a pair of boots. Best to go to a store that is hiking and camping related because they're going to be able to provide you a better nuanced view of foot care than perhaps if you go to an ABC Mart or something like that. So that's one thing. The second thing is buy online only once you have tried them on store. So if you think you can find them cheaper online, great. No problem. I have no problems with that. But do try to make sure you get a chance to try those boots on first before you actually purchase them. That's the second thing. Now, quickly, how do we actually fit our boots? Well, let's say this is our boot here, okay, and this is my foot. What I want to do is I want to make sure that the heel of my foot goes snugly into the heel of the boot, right? So you don't want to have it so that it's up like this. You actually want to be able to push your foot back into the heel of the boot, and you want to have probably at least a centimeter. Even just, you could even just say a thumb's width would be an appropriate distance. You want to have a thumb's width between your longest toe and the front of the boot, okay? That way you got your toes have some wiggle room, and when your foot is right back into the heel of the boot, you've got a little bit of toe room in the front. Those are the two main things you want to be thinking about when buying a pair of boots and foot care in generally. The third part of your foot is actually the widest point, right? Everybody's foot is different, so where that widest point is going to be, you want to make sure that the boot is not too snug around that area and that it has material perhaps that will be able to expand with that particular part of your foot, okay? And once you've picked the right footwear, it's important for you to break in your boots or hiking shoes, no matter what they are. Don't just run out into the, don't start going out hiking and, you know, take them outside, walk them around the house. The boots are going to be clean when they come off. Keep them on for an hour to 2 hours every day and just get your feet, excuse me, just get your feet and your boots kind of acclimatized to what's going to be happening. So that's boots. Second thing, socks. A lot of people think, just throw on my sport socks and it's good to go. Can't be more wrong on that. Make sure when you're trying on your boots, you try on your boots with a pair of socks that are designed for hiking. Typically have cushion or a thicker area of sock where there's going to be more pressure. So there's going to be more pressure, obviously, on the bottom of the foot and typically on the top of the foot. On the sides, it's usually not as thick on those sides, on the sides of your feet. So you're going to have a little more cushion where your laces and the tongue of the boot goes up, as well on the bottom of your foot. If you already have a pair of hiking socks, bring those along with you and try your socks with the specific boot that you're looking at. There are some products that you can have that actually perhaps keep yourself from getting into a blister or a hot spot zone. There's all sorts of powders, all sorts of Vaseline-based products that you can use on specific areas of your feet. Now, I have never used those, but I do know a lot of people have those or use them. Now, the one thing I do recommend is keep your feet, socks, and boots dry as much as you can. Now, of course, we're going to be outside, and there are times when our boots and socks are going to get wet. Maybe we slip and fall and put our foot in a stream or something like that. It happens. It's not a big deal. However, what you do want to do on a normal hike where that situation doesn't happen is about halfway through your hike, stop, take your boots off, take your socks off, and let your feet dry out. Okay? Couple reasons why. Number one, you're going to be able to see where perhaps the laces are a bit too tight around the top of your foot, and you can then adjust your laces. Another thing is you can give both feet a quick check to see how they're doing. If you're noticing any red spots, you'll know that that's a warning sign that something is coming. All right. The other thing is when our feet get overly damp inside of a boot, that can actually lead to some significant wrinkling in your foot. And when that happens, it can actually, once the boots are off, it can actually create some problems and even some pain in your feet if you're not careful. So being aware of those things, very important. Okay, let's keep going. Next one. Blisters, okay? If you've done everything before, proper fitting boots, proper socks, especially breaking in your boots, there's a very good chance that you won't have blisters. However, that's not to say that you're not going to have them. So, as you are walking, probably for the first few hundred meters, you want to be able to see how your feet are reacting to the hike. It may very well be that you're starting to feel something in your foot. That's called a hot spot. This is not a blister, but if left unchecked, it very much well could be. So, stop, take your boots off, take your socks off, and examine your feet for the hot spot. Toenails. This is the last thing that you might want to consider before going out on a trip. Trim your toenails. Toenails can often, in fact, get in the way of a perfectly good fit. A well-fitting boot. The reason is, if your toenails are hanging past the end of your toe, that reduces the amount of room between your toe and the edge of the boot. Fingernails. Your fingernails, you go around. Your toenails, you cut straight, okay? That way, you've got a flat surface rather than a rounded surface. You also don't want to cut to the quick on your toenail. That can cause additional pain when you're hiking. And you also want to cut slightly at an angle like this. Okay. There's the top five or six things that you should do when it comes to foot care. Please leave a link below. Tell me what you do when you're out and about on your grand, glorious hike. Thanks very much, everybody. Stay tuned for the extra special video next Wednesday. Like, share, subscribe to the channel, and remember, live life well. Take care, everybody, and have a great day.